जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णां जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयो प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहु।
The Gospel of the Holy Mother Sri Sharada Devi, Reminiscences and Conversations recorded by Swami Arupananda. Place Jayarambati, February 1907. I intended to return home on the day before the Shivratri, as I wanted to attend Sri Ramakrishna's birthday celebration at Belur Math, which came off 2 days after the Shivratri. I told the mother about it, but she asked me to go to Kamarpukur first. I had left home with a great yearning to see the Holy Mother alone, and in my eagerness, I had forgotten to take my umbrella or any extra piece of cloth. At the request of the mother, I agreed to visit Holy Kamarpukur, the birthplace of Sri Ramakrishna. She gave me a fresh piece of cloth to put on and asked me to take it with me. Mother, have you any money with you? You will require carriage hire. Take the money from me. Arupananda, I have money with me. I have not to take it from you. Mother, write to me after you reach home. I could not feed my son properly. I could not prepare anything good for him. I prostrated myself before her and set out with tears in my eyes. The Holy Mother accompanied us for some distance and then watched us till we were out of sight. I could not refrain from weeping out of devotion for her till I had reached Kamarpukur. After my arrival at Kamarpukur, I was shown the room where the Holy Mother had lived. There I saw the picture of the mother, which made me still more restless to see her again. Next day, Master Mahashay, the author of the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna, and Prabodh Babu went to Jayarambati via Kamarpukur, halting at the latter place for a few hours. In the evening, Lalit Babu, a disciple of the mother, arrived there. He was on his way to Jayarambati. As it would be difficult for me to go from Kamarpukur to Kolkata alone, some devotee suggested that I might revisit Jayarambati and go to Kolkata in the company of Lalit Babu. So I went with him to Jayarambati once again and said to the mother, "I am here again." The mother was greatly pleased and said, "That is good. You can go to Kolkata with Lalit." After the Shivratri festival was over, the devotees sat down for their meals. They were served some prasada on leaf plates. I asked them what it was. They said that it was the prasada of the Holy Mother. I also partook of it. Later on, I said to the mother, "They all enjoyed your prasada, but you have never offered it to me." "My child," said the mother, "you never asked for it How could I suggest it? Oof, what great humility. The next afternoon, I left with the party for Kolkata. The mother had told Lalit Babu about me. He is very devoted to God. Please take him with you. We all prostrated ourselves before the mother. Her eyes became filled with tears. She was moved to tears as she accompanied us to the outer gate of the house. At Vishnupur, on our way to Kolkata, Master Mahashay, Prabodh Babu and others visited the shrine of Mrinmayee, an aspect of the Divine Mother. But Lalit Babu and I directly went to the railway station and boarded the train. Master Mahashay sent Prabodh Babu to request us also to visit the shrine. But we did not care to see Mrinmayee, that is, Goddess made of earth, as we had seen Chinmayee, a living goddess, Shri Sharada Devi. I arrived at the Belur Math, and after witnessing Sri Ramakrishna's birthday festival, returned home. Janani Sarada Devi Ramakrishna Jagat Guru Pada Padme Tayo Sritva Pranamami.